Hello dear friends, hope you all are doing good. So this video is regarding the balance 51 to 100 MCQs of the recently released ICAI MCQs, right? Did you see the last video? I hope you have done. And these all MCQs are there in the ISCA PDF. The link to buy that at 50% discount is available in the description box below. I also request you to see the 8 days revision videos, which are almost 1.5 hours max for each chapter. So you can cover the ISCA revision because you have other 3 important papers to take care, and this ISCA should not cause a problem, right? Okay, now without much delay, let's get started with the 51st question. What does it say now? Ms. PQR Limited is a BPO managing the health records of a renowned hospital in Mumbai. Okay, they're managing the health records. It was observed that one of the employees, Mr. X, was sharing the confidential health records of the patients with an insurance company. So he's trying to share the details of the health to insurance company and make some money out of it. Who will be held responsible under the IT Act for the offence? So here Mr. X is sharing the records. So is he responsible? No, he and the directors are responsible. Why? Because the directors must have proper internal controls in the organization, right? And Mr. X must not do such kind of wrong thing. So he and directors are responsible. And shareholders are nowhere responsible because they don't know what's happening inside the company, right? So Mr. X and the directors are responsible for this offense. Okay. Then ABC Limited is engaged in providing data processing services. Okay. It has received a big contract from insurance company for the policy processing. ABC Limited has limited PCs at their office, so it approached Amazon Web Services to access virtual machines for data processing. ABC Limited is using the cloud computing model. If you understand and if you have gone through chapter number 8, we are talking about the usage of virtual machines, virtual PCs, because the company has a limited desktop. So we are trying to use a virtual infrastructure, isn't it? So as we are using the desktop to get the processing done in the form of virtual machines, we are trying to use the infrastructure service. Therefore, which type of cloud computing model we are using? We are using infrastructure as a service. Then, which of the following statement is incorrect? IT steering committee is ideally led by a member of the board of the director and the comprised of functional head from all key areas. Okay, key departments of the enterprise, including the audit and IT department. Of course, this is the right statement, it is not wrong, because IT steering committee is led by one of the members of the board and has all head of the departments participating in it. Then, the role and responsibility of IT steering committee and its members must be documented and approved by senior management. So, the roles and responsibilities has to be declared and defined, right? Then, so it is also a correct statement. The IT steering committee provides overall direction to the deployment of IT and information systems enterprise. It provides overall direction. That's also correct. Then the last point, the project manager should work independently from the steering committee in finalizing the detailed work plan and developing interview schedules. No, this is wrong. Actually, the project manager has not too much of coordination with the IT steering committee, but he must have a good talk or good communication with the IT steering committee to do any work related to the IT thing, right? So this statement is incorrect here with the regards to IT steering committee. Then in an organization, the top management generally comprises of whom and whom. So we general top management, what does whom do all the top management include? Let us see. Owners or shareholders, board of directors, its chairman, managing director or the chief executive. Okay. Heads of the function department and purchase manager, production manager, marketing manager. These people will come in the middle level management, not top management. Then marketing manager, functional controller, divisional sectional officer, working under functional heads. This also comes in the middle level. Superintendents and supervisors may come in the middle, but still it is just above the bottom level. So only the first answer, owner, shareholder, board of directors, chairman, managing director or the chief executive, generally comprises of the top management, is the right answer. Then, an information security policy addresses many issues that may involve the following. What does it involve? It can involve confidentiality, integrity and availability. Yes, of course. Then, who may access what information and in what manner, based upon which access decision is made. Yes, information security policy must show and must give a clear understanding as to who can access what type of information and from where. Then, maximize sharing versus least privilege and segregation of duties. So, the security policy must emphasize on who can do the sharing and what are the highest possibility of the things that can be shared and what is the least areas which cannot be shared. Then programming new system, maintaining old system, and providing general support software. This one is programming and maintenance done by the maintenance schedule, maintenance policy, but not by security policy. So 1, 2, and 3 will form part of the security policy of any organization. Okay. Then which of the following statement is incorrect? Again, the incorrect statement comes: a full backup captures all files in the disk or within the folder selected for backup. Yes, it covers everything. Then the mirror backup is clean and does not contain old and obsolete files. Yes, it deletes the file for every 30 days. With the differential backup, one full backup is done first and then subsequent backups runs are the changes made since the last full backup. If you have seen in the last video, we have seen the difference between incremental and differential backup. So differential backup, we must have a first full backup. So that is also correct. Incremental backup consumes the most storage space as compared to full and differential backup. No, incremental backup does not cover much spaces as compared to any other backup. It takes minimum nominal space only. So this is the incorrect statement of this question. Which of the following activities is not involved in database designing during the designing phase of the system development lifecycle? Among the four, this is not involved in designing itself. So what are these? Storage structure, it is a part of the database design. Cost analysis, no, we don't do any analysis for the cost while developing a database, right? Then physical layout design, yes, in database design we need a physical layout. And then conceptual modeling, how this data should be there. So A, C and D will form part of the database design, but not B. Okay. Next, the audit trail of dash maintains the chronology of the event. When you see this thing, I immediately get the answer, but still, the audit trail of dash maintains the chronology of the event from the time data is received from the input or communication subsystem to the time data is dispatched to the database communication or output subsystem. So what is thing happening? You are receiving the data, then the data is getting processed, and then the data is being dispatched as output. So all when these things happen, from starting input, processing, output, it will maintain the audit trail. So which system maintains audit trail? We are not focusing on output, we are not focused on storage of data, we are not focused on communication also. What we are focused is the process, input, processing and output. So processing control is the right answer, because it has the audit trail which maintains the chronology of the events from the time input is received into the system by the time it goes as an output. Then in Information Technology Act 2000, dash is defined as a person in whose name electronic signature certificate is issued. So whose name it is issued, the person is called as subscriber. Okay, controller is a person who is seeing who are receiving the things. Intermediary is a person not related to the digital signature at all. Originator is also not related to digital signature. So only the person on whose name the digital signature is issued or digital signature certificate is issued is called as subscriber. Okay. Next. Which of the following issue is not related to security in mobile computing? So confidentiality, integrity and accountability will be the security issues. But what is not security issue? Bandwidth means the signal strength is not an issue regarding the security. It is related to performance thing. Then information systems and action device, procedure, technique or other measure that reduces the vulnerability of the component in it is referred to as DASC. So what the action, device, procedure, technique or other measure which will reduce the vulnerability, so it will reduce the chances of any weakness in system. What is that? It is not residual risk. Residual risk is the risk that is left after all proper measures are taken. Then countermeasure, yes, it reduces the vulnerability. Risk management, it gives a protection, it never reduces, it helps us to manage the risk. And threat is something which is due to the vulnerability. So countermeasure is the right answer, which reduces the vulnerability of a component. Next, which of the following activity is not involved in office automation system? So office automation system, if you go to chapter number 2, we have many activities there. We have document creation, okay, and we have filing, search, retrieval and follow-up, receipts and distribution. What we don't have is decision making. Office automation system will try to ease the working method or working structure of the office, but it will never help in making any decision. So that is not an activity involved in office automation, okay, office automation systems. Then which of the following is not a type of application control under the accounts under the controls classified based upon the audit function? So what is it saying? Which of the following among the four is not a type of application control? It is not a type of application control, and the controls classified based upon the OAuth function. If you have seen in the OAuth function, we have classification and we have application control. Is one of the classification of OAuth function, chapter number 6. So in that we have input control, boundary control, processing control, output control. We have those things, but the control we don't have on security administration. So that is the odd man out, because it is not a type of application control under the audit functions. That's why we need to cover the earlier chapters before coming into this kind of MCQ. So don't worry if you are unable to recollect, go to chapter number 6. You have 1 hour of video, revise it, or you can take my last day revision notes where you have the side headings. It's almost 200 pages plus last day revision, but it's very effective. It is 200 pages plus, not that so much of content is there, everything has been covered in it. But thing is that the font has been a bit high, so that it doesn't cause inconvenience to the students. That's why it's more lengthy there. And then even you have MCQ question bank covering all the MCQs chapter wise, around 400, and again MCQs from RTP, MTP, mock test, and even this MCQ which you're seeing now. So it's very much effort has been done in making those two PDF, and you can get it at 50% off in the links are given in the description box below, where you can even afford for the combo book, combination of both last day revision and MCQs. Okay, then which of the following document is not classified as being a part of the business continuity management system? So which among the four is not a part of, not a document of the business continuity management system? The risk assessment report, yeah, it is a part. Business impact analysis report, it is a part. Local authority risk register, it is a part of the documents regarding business continuity management system. But performance analysis report, we don't see the performance for any business continuity. We see performance for the business is very good, so that is not a part of the business continuity performance report. Then under the which dimension the feasibility study under the system development lifecycle is not evaluated? So feasibility is not seen in which level? We see feasibility in technical, legal and operational feasibility, but we not see the feasibility for the incremental level. Incremental means trying to increase the capacity. So for that, what feasibility study can you see? To have the increasing thing, we see the technical, legal and operational, but feasibility as such for the incremental aspect is not taken care in the SDLC. Next, which of the following is not an example of information system audit tool? Of course, we have, if audit tools, if we see, we have SCARF, ITF, audit hooks, continuous intermittent simulation, right? But we don't have a flow chart. So flow chart is not an example of, it is a tool for structured programming language. It is a tool for that, but it is not an audit tool. Then which of the following is not an enterprise management practice required aligning IT strategy with enterprise strategy? So what among these four is not required for mapping enterprise management practices with IT strategy? Okay, which of the following four is not an enterprise management practices which are required? So enterprise must have a practices in line which is required for aligning IT strategy with enterprise strategy, right? So in among the four, which is not that? First, define target IT capabilities. Yes, you must have the target IT capabilities in order to understand if the enterprise can manage the enterprise strategy, can manage and get the IT strategy in place. Then assessing the current environment capability and performance, exactly. Communicating IT strategy and direction. So these three ABC are required to align IT strategy with the enterprise strategy. We must know the IT capacity, we must know the current environment, we must communicate the IT strategy, then only we can align both with the both IT strategy and the enterprise strategy. But mitigating the risk is not a right answer. Why? Because we understand the business, we take care of the risk and we develop risk management strategies, but always all risk management strategy need not be with the IT. So the information and technology strategy need not be focused only on risk management, right? That is the reason this one will be odd man out. So risk management will be a part of the overall business management, or can be seen independently, the risk management for the entire business. But risk management is not only specific to IT. That is the reason it is the right answer for the question. Next, in an interview, okay, a candidate was asked to mention all about the components of enterprise resource planning. model that can be implemented through a methodology. Identify the correct answer that may be given by the candidate. So what he is saying, identify all those components required for ERP. We need a software component. We need a let us try to recreate for ERP. What do we need? We need software component, process flow, customer mindset, and change management. So okay, we have software component in A, B, C, and D. Okay, we have process flow in A, B, C, and D. We have customer mindset, business application, customer mindset, business application. Okay, between A and C, one should be the answer. The last, change management. Okay, change management, hardware component. So A is the answer. So ERP components are software component, process flow, customer mindset, and change management. Now comes 69th one. Identify the correct statement out of the following. Okay, it's saying we need to find out the correct statement. Let us try. To have a proper backup procedure in an enterprise is a best example prevent to control. Have a proper backup. Having a proper backup is not a prevent to control. Prevent to control is not to let the risk happen, but it is a kind of a correct to control where you can even try to get the things on a proper place after the disaster happens. So it is not the correct statement. Then logical access controls related to logical security. Nah, it is not related to only security, related to many other things of the system, right? Logical access control are related to logical security of the tangible information resource and intangible resource stored on a tangible media. So it is not just related to logical security, but even relates to every aspect of including logical communication, storage, etc. of the information on a logical system there. So that's also not a correct answer. Then piggybacking is defined as an act of following an authorized person through a secure door or electronically attaching to an authorized telecommunication link that intercepts and alters transmission. Exactly, piggybacking, what we do, we try to follow a secured door or secured path or for authorized person and get access to the system as if when the secured person or authorized person gets access to system. So we try to follow them and try to make the alterations in the transmission. So that is the right answer. Then the internetwork device bridge connects heterogeneous local area network. So the bridge generally connects heterogeneous things, but it's not just related to local area network. It can even connect the wider network also. So here this piggybacking is the right answer. Okay, next, which of the following statement is incorrect with respect to differential backup? Let us try. Okay, first thing, with the differential backup, one full backup is done first and subsequent backups are the changes made since the last full backup. It is the right answer. Then differential backup is faster and more economical in using the backup space. Of course, it is correct. Differential backup are faster than incremental backup. No, it is slower compared to incremental backup. Then with mirror backup, when a file is deleted, the file is eventually also deleted in the mirror backup. That is true. So only what is the wrong answer? Then differential backup are faster than the incremental backup. It is not. They're actually a bit slower compared to incremental backup. Then in an organization, as most of the information system require some modification after development, the system maintenance phase becomes one of an important aspect of SDLC. There are different categories of maintenance which are scheduled, adaptive, corrective, rescue, preventive, and perfective. Which of the following statement is not correct regarding the categories of maintenance? Okay, let us see. Scheduled maintenance is planned to ensure operational continuity to avoid anticipated risk. Yeah, that is true. Operational continuity is taken in scheduled maintenance. Rescue maintenance deals with undetected malfunction that requires immediate troubleshooting solution. Definitely, we need to do something immediately. It is taken care of by the rescue maintenance. Adaptive maintenance mainly deals with accommodating to a new or changed user requirement and concerns. Functional enhancement to the system. Adaptive maintenance not only deals with accommodating new or changed requirements or functional aspects, and even sees the adapting to the new environment, dealing or new environment or new technology, things that happen, anything that happens new to the any part of the operating system or management or development and technology is taken care of by adaptive system. It is not restricted to only user requirement or functional aspects. Then corrective maintenance deals with fixing bugs in the code or defect found during execution. That is also correct. Only the adaptive maintenance concept is the incorrect one in the among the four. Then which of the following statement is incorrect with respect to auditing of information system? The planning phase in IS audit ensures that the audit is performed in effective manner. That's true. It is a correct statement. The IS audit process evaluates the adequacy of the internal control regarding both specific computer program and the data processing environment. The process will evaluate both the internal controls regarding specific computer program and data processing environment. That's true. The IS auditor should satisfy not only the effectiveness of the various technical controls but also the overall control safeguarding the business against environmental risk. Yes, in the IS audit he has to see that the technical controls are effectively working and the overall controls safeguarding the business are also properly working. He must take care of that. So it is also correct. Then according to SA 234, do we have something like that? Audit documentation refers to record of audit procedure performed, relevant audit obtained and conclusion audit reached. Audit documentation definition is given properly, but it is SA 230, not 234. So this is the incorrect statement here. Then, which of the following definition is incorrect in purview of the Information Technology Act? Among the four, which one is not correct regarding to Information Technology Act? Let us see. Electronic form with reference to information means any information generated, sent, received or stored in media, magnetic, optical, computer, memory, microfilm, computer generated, microfridge or similar devices. That is true. Correct. Addressee means a person including intermediary who is intended by the originator to receive the electronic record. That is also true. Cybercafe means any facility from where access to the internet is offered by any person in the ordinary course of business to the members in the public. That's actually a correct answer. Okay. Then asymmetric crypto system means system of secure keypair consisting of private key for creating digital signature and public key to verify the digital signature. That is also correct. Then what is incorrect here? Let us see. Addressee means a person including intermediary. No, addressee never includes intermediary. Addressee includes a person to whom the device to whom the electronic record is intended to receive. It never includes an intermediary. So this is the wrong answer. Then below are the facts related to the community cloud. However, there is one statement which is incorrect. So among the community cloud, what is incorrect? First one, as the complete cloud is shared by several organizations or community, it becomes highly expensive. It is affordable. Only thing is that there is no automation is lost because many people are involved in the cloud. Then community cloud is suitable for organizations that cannot afford a private cloud and cannot rely on other public cloud either. That is true. Community cloud has better security than public cloud, as some sort of privacy is still there, security is still there. The cloud is distributed and no single company has full control over the whole cloud. That's also correct. Only the first tip, the complete cloud being shared by several organizations becomes expensive, is the incorrect answer. Which of the following statement is incorrect? Again, among the four, which of the following is incorrect? The enterprise, regardless of size, needs to have an internal control system built into enterprise structure. That is true. The IT steering committee of an enterprise provides overall direction to the deployment of IT and information system in the enterprise. That is also true. Vulnerability of software can originate from the flaws of the software design. Okay. Defects in its implementation or problems in operation. It can originate from any part of this three, either in design or implementation or operation. The GRC framework, which has been regulatory requirement not only for listed companies but also for all type of enterprise, stands for Governance, Risk and Control. What is in the GRC framework, which has been a regulatory requirement not only for listed companies but also for all type of enterprise, stands for Governance, Risk and Control, GRC. Okay. No, because it is a Governance, Risk and Compliance. It is not control. So that is the wrong answer here. Okay. Then which of the following statement is not correct about the management information system, MIS? So which of them are correct? MIS usually take 1 to 3 years and sometimes even longer period to get established firmly within the company. Of course it takes. MIS cannot be implemented without using a computer. Which of the following is not correct? Okay, MIS is integrated that takes comprehensive view or complete look into the interlocking subsystem that operate within a company. Okay, then which of the following is not correct, means incorrect? MIS cannot be implemented without using a computer. In general, computer is not essential but is required for efficient functioning of MIS. So MIS cannot be implemented without using of the computer is not a correct statement, is incorrect statement. What is the correct statement? It needs computer to be implemented. But it's not. But a computer will increase the efficiency of the MIS. That's why we say MIS is cannot be implemented. Sorry, MIS can be implemented without the use of computer also. But having a computer will enhance the functioning of MIS. That's why the statement saying that MIS cannot be implemented without a computer is an incorrect statement. Why? MIS can be implemented without a computer, but having a computer will enhance the functioning of the MIS. Okay, and MIS can be broken into meaningful subsystems that set the stage for phasing plan. Yes, it is a correct answer. So what is the wrong statement here? B. MIS cannot be implemented without using a computer. Then, which of the following statement is incorrect with respect to various controls implemented in organization? The suppressed take of raw material stock by supervisor in an manufacturing company example of correct to control? No, it's an example of prevent to control. Suppressed take you're doing so that you don't it doesn't happen that people swindle off the raw materials, right? It's a preventive check, it's not corrective. Then the contingency planning done by enterprise example of correct to control. Contingency planning, yes, you are trying to maintain if anything mishap happens, the contingency event occurs, you need to give a backup thing. So it's a correct to control. Firewalls are installed in organization as a part of prevent to control. Yes, firewalls are done to prevent any wrongful malicious thing coming into the network. Duplicate checking of calculation in the financial transaction of an enterprise is an example of direct to control. Yes, we tend to detect any errors taken place in the financial transaction. So, suppressed check of raw material stock by supervisor in a manufacturing company is an example of direct to control is an incorrect statement. In a business impact analysis matrix, also known as risk assessment matrix, risks are placed on a matrix based upon the two likely criteria. What are the criteria here? First thing is likelihood. Yes, I mean till what level, what is the more chances that there can be a risk taking place, okay? And depending upon the chances of having that risk, what can be the consequence if the risk manifests? So likelihood and the consequence is the x and y axis of the business impact analysis matrix. During the system testing in system development lifecycle, the software and other system elements are tested as a whole. Which of the following is not type of system testing? Not type of system testing is generally, we have security testing to know security, we have performance testing to see how the system is being working, we see recovery testing if anything happens, but is that we don't have anything called alpha testing. Alpha testing comes under the unit testing concept there. So how to do the component testing, we do the alpha testing, but not for the entire system as a whole. Then, which of the following is a correct sequence of steps involved in information system audit? I think this has been covered in our MCQs of chapter number 6 also. First thing, we do scoping. So, let us say scoping is in A and D. Okay, scoping, then we do planning. Then we do field work. So, D is the scoping, planning, field work, analysis, reporting and closure. Then, the students of an institute are usually required to create documents like charts, graphs, handouts, preparing documents, dictation and editing of text. Which of the following information system is suitable for carrying out these functions? So, this is generally done by these features of office automation system. So, office automation system is the right answer for these kind of activities to be done by the students. Then, though Mr. X, an accountant, is involved in system development work, which of the following is not an expected skill set to be acquired by the accountant in order to perform his duty? He must be expert in bookkeeping, yes. He must understand the business objective. He must do cost-benefit analysis, but he need not have an knowledge or skill for understanding system development methodology. He need not have knowledge of waterfall model or spiral model or prototyping model. He need not have that skill set in mind there, okay? Then, which of the following statements are not correct with respect to management and its levels? So, among these four, which is not right respect to management and its levels? Senior management responsible for strategic planning, exactly, and objectives, and thus setting the course in the line of business that the company will pursue. Exactly, he is responsible. The level of management are fixed to three irrespective of size and structure. Yes, the levels of management will be top, middle and bottom. So, that is also correct. Then, middle management develops tacital plans, activities and functions that accomplish a strategic objective. No, middle management implements what the senior management told them. So, they never do that tacital kind of activity. So, that is incorrect. That is not the right statement here. Then, supervisory management oversees and controls the daily activities and functions of the tacital plan. Exactly, the supervisory management will see what the above people have told and how the things are being done. So, what is the incorrect statement? The C answer. Then, the key management practices involved in implementation of risk management enterprise are as follows. What are the key management practices involved here? We have analyzed the risk. Yes, that will be the first one. So, sorry. analyze the risk, articulate, respond, collect, maintain, and define. Okay, first we will collect the data. So fourth option is here. See, that is a B answer should be the answer for you. First we collect the data, then we analyze the risk. Then what we do? We maintain risk profile. Then we articulate the risk. Then we define a risk management action portfolio, and then we respond to a risk. That is a sequence of plan happening here. Okay, identify which of the following is not a principle of COBIT 5. Not a principle of COBIT 5. First thing, meeting stakeholders' needs, covering enterprise end to end, applying a single integrated framework, separating governance from management. Yes, but we don't have in the COBIT 5 the principle of evaluate and direct risk management. We don't have this thing as one of the principles of COBIT 5. Next. Under the phase of feasibility study of SDLC, what possible dimension of the proposed web-based knowledge portal system is said to have been compromised in a situation where students of XYZ University were not being able to access the e-resources available on university website? Means the resources, the XYZ University has many e-records, e-books on their website. The students are given login and password to access it, but when they enter, they are unable to find that, or when they want to access it, the login ID were not working. So which component of the feasibility study that the university system is a university knowledge portal is said to have been compromised? Is it technical? Is it resource? Is it behavior? Is it economic? So technical will not form part of the answer. Technical is something which is backend. The person developing the knowledge management system must take care of it. It is not the resource. Resource means what the university must provide to the people, to the person who is developing the web-based knowledge portal system. It is not related to economics, not cost benefit analysis, but it is related to behavior. What behavior expected from the knowledge portal? Whenever the student try to access the resource over the website, he must be able to see that resource there. It has not been able to see it. So it is a behavioral feasibility that has been compromised here. Okay. Then identify the information system that would be useful for organization in case it wishes to remotely access document for internal communication. So remotely it want to access the internal documents, and it is for the internal communication, means communication in the organization only. So we have documentation management, and documentation accessing will always happen in the electronic document management system. Next, which of the following statement is incorrect respect to decision support system? So in decision support system, which of the following is not correct? A DSS includes one or more database that contain both routine and non-routine data from both internal and external resources. Yes, DSS may include one or more database. That is actually correct statement. The DSS is intended to make decision for the managers in solving semi-structured and unstructured problems in their own. No, it helps them in decision making, but it does not make decisions for them. So this is the statement which is not correct. Then the model base of the brain of DSS as it performs data manipulation and computations with the data provided to it by the user and database is exactly, it is a brain which provides computations. DSS is an interactive software based system intended to help the decision makers to compile useful information from the raw data, documents and personal knowledge. It is a software based system that helps the decision makers to compile useful information depending upon the documents and personal knowledge and helps them in making a decision. So all these three are correct, only the incorrect thing is point B. Then, during a system acquisition in SDLC, the top management of an enterprise should establish acquisition standards that addresses the security and reliability issues as per the current state of art development standards. So when you're trying to acquire a system, the top management must have in place the standards for acquiring then the required hardware software components, and that standard must address the security and reliability issues as per the recent developments in the environment. Which of the following is not considered while focusing on the acquisition standards? What you will not consider? First, you see that you will ensure the security, reliability and functionality is already built into the product. You see all these things are there or not. Then you see managers complete reviews of the appropriate vendor, contract and licensing. You see the reviews on the particular vendor. Then you send request to proposal, solicit bids. While acquiring off the shelf or third party software, you try to send the request proposal, and which proposal you find it better, you then try to acquire the third party software. Then to select a programming technique and language to be used for system development. When you're acquiring software, you'll not try to work out on the programming technique, because programming technique is something is different, but acquiring software is something is different. So this one is not a particular not to be taken care of while developing acquisition standards. Then, because programming technique is for developing a particular program, it has nothing to do with acquisition of the hardware, right? Then, which of the following statement is incorrect with respect to auditing of information systems? Okay, audit trail attempts to ensure that there is a chronological record of all the events that occurred in organizations are maintained. Yes, audit trail tries to maintain the chronological event. Then, one of the audit techniques named integrated test facility is used to trap exceptions whenever the application system uses DBMS. So, integrated test facility is not to trap exceptions. Integrated test facility will try to introduce a dummy data and see how the data goes in the entire system. So, that is the wrong answer. Then, a boundary control under application control maintains the chronology of the event that occurs when a user attempts to gain access to an employee system resource. That is true. It maintains such kind of controls. Then, while auditing, an auditor must check that the risk assessment procedure adequately covers periodic and timely assessment of all the assets and physical asset threat. Yes, auditor will try to see that the risk assessment procedure will cover all the periodic and timely assessment of both physical assets and threat to the assets. So only what is wrong is the integrated test facility definition. Then, Mr. Radesh, an accountant, is working on return on investment analysis of the company ABC Limited. For this analysis, he requires different types of data. Below is a list of different types of data that the company may have. Which of the following data is not required for Mr. Radesh for carrying out his work? He needs to know what is the development cost. He needs to know what is the operational cost in doing this kind of when implementing the data, which can influence the return on investment. He must know what is the tangible intangible cost, but he need not know what is the incremental cost as of now. Okay, so when he is doing the ROI, he need not have the knowledge of incremental cost as of now. That happens when the project takes place, but initially what is return given in the project must be calculated, so he need not have incremental cost data. Okay, next. Mr. Ravi, an internal auditor of XYZ insurance company, determined that the company's policyholder system was vulnerable to fraud, as in every time a policyholder changed his address or name to get the funds withdrawn from the policy subsequently. He devised the system by using one of the audit tools to tag all the records. Remember the word tagging. Tag all the records with a change in the name or address so that the internal audit department could investigate these tagged records for detecting the fraud. Which type of audit tool he is using? He is not working continuously, so A is not answer. He is not taking any photographs of the transaction. He is not using any dummy data. He is trying to catch those. He want to tag those transactions which are having the request for change of name or address. So audit trail will be the proper auditing tool used by such auditor. Then, top management of Karol Limited, and company based in Tamil Nadu, strategically planned and initiated its new branch in Bangalore. Identify from the following the incorrect statement about the strategic planning. Okay, the primary plan that guides the long-run development of the enterprise. A strategic plan is the primary plan. Okay, it is a process by which top management determines overall organization purpose and objective. Yes, it is a process of assuring the specific tasks are carried out effectively and efficiently. No, then. It is a process that determines how organization objectives are being achieved. Yes, how they are achieving, what we are doing to achieve is taken care of. But it will not assure that all activities done effectively and efficiently. So what to do, how we are achieving is given by the strategic plan. But is it done efficiently or effectively or not is not given by that plan. Therefore, that is the statement not correct with respect to strategic planning. Then, Charole Limited, a washing machine manufacturer company, identifies some risks related to its sensors used in the machine. To address the concern, the management plans a strategy that involves its trading partner and supplier KLM Limited for providing the Internet of Things sensors to be installed in the new models of washing machine. Which risk management strategy is being followed? So they identify some risk with the sensors. So they're trying to install in the new model certain sensors to know what kind of risk they're trying to do. So here they want to build the sensors so that they can remove that risk. So they identified some risk with sensors. So they're asking the partner or supplier to provide them some of the sensors to be installed in the new model. So what they're doing, if they don't do that, the risk will arise. So they're not accepting the risk. They're not sharing the risk. They're not mitigating it, but they're trying to eliminate the risk by giving more sensors in the upcoming new model. So that is eliminating risk concept in the question. Then, the electronic mode of the communication has evolved as a solo alternative during the period of lockdown and pandemic COVID-19. Exactly. Various offices, education institutions, and companies initiated electronic means via teleconferencing, video conferencing through different web applications like Zoom, right, to approach their client, employees, customers, and hold a virtual meeting of the communication to resolve the grievances of the customers. That's true. These teleconferencing and video conferencing means of communication system can be classified as dash. So this teleconferencing and video conferencing, what we're trying to do is called, is it operational level system? No. Is it the MIS? No. Is it strategic? No. It is knowledge level system. In knowledge level system, we are trying to use these telephonic conversation, and we're trying to have the virtual meeting, right, teleconferencing, video conference stuff in the pandemic time also. Then GPS route planning provides the fastest route between starting and destination point by analyzing and comparing various possible routes on real-time basis. Identify which system is used for GPS. In GPS, what we do, we try to use, come on, you can try, we can try to use the decision support system. Why? The system is going to see the distance between the starting and ending and try to see the best route with the minimum traffic. So it's trying the and giving all other alternate possibilities also. So it's giving a chance to the person to take a decision of which route he wants to go. Accordingly, when he chooses, that direction is followed by the Google, and it will the GPS, it will try to give you the way depending upon the route you selected. So decision support system is the answer. It is not management information system. Because we are not the manager, we are not executive, we are not dealing with any knowledge systems also, but we are trying to take a decision to go to a particular destination, right? Okay, then on stealing a credit card of Mr. Amit, Mr. Suraj telephoned Mr. Amit pretending himself as a bank employee and informed that his credit card has been found. Mr. Suraj convinced Mr. Amit that to avoid any fraud, his existing credit card should be blocked and the new credit card shall be issued to him by the bank. On the pretext of verification, Mr. Suraj insisted Mr. Amit to share his credit card PIN. Mr. Amit shared PIN of Mr. Suraj and made a purchase of 5,000. Which of the following technique Mr. Suraj he come to commit a cyber fraud? So he acted as a bank employee. He tried to be the mask of a bank employee. So he did a masquerading. Means he is trying to act as someone who is not. Right? He did not do anything with the data. He did not do any internet terrorism. He did not do dumpster driving. Means he didn't do any of things on the cyber world. He tried to wear a mask of a bank employee and pretended him to be a bank employee and did the cyber crime. So it is masquerading technique. Okay. Then MXN developer software company has a development of backup facility on which recovery time for the company's operation in the case of disaster 24 hours or lesser. What do you think a most suitable backup facility with the company? So the requirement they need there to be the requirement for the backup is such that they need the things to be backed up in 24 hours or less. So what it's a very small time, right? Within one day you want everything to be backed up, the data must be backed up. So they need the hot site. They are not ready to be slow. So they need hot site for the backup facility. ABC Limited and XYZ Limited signed a reciprocal agreement. Okay, there's something alternate processing facilities, right? To provide backup facility to each other in the event of one suffering the disaster. Sooner both the parties, there's a reciprocal agreement, right? Soon both the parties realized that the reciprocal agreement is not a suitable alternative for offset backup because of the following reason. Is it expensive? No, it's manageable. Slow response to request, we can have a medium good response. Network incompatibility, it can be managed. Difficulty in maintaining sufficient capacity to operate another critical system. Yes, we can't maintain someone's system as in the manner as they wanted, right? So that is a difficulty because it is not the regular work that they do. They have their own works to do, but if suddenly one system is coming and asking a backup thing, these people can't arrange that fast. Right, that is the answer. They are finding it difficult. Last question. Softtech, a software development company that has clients in many fields like pharmaceutical, educational, health industry, etc. The company follows the approach to develop the software by releasing multiple versions wherein each version has something more added to it than its previous version. Identify the system approach adopted by Softtech. So every time you are having something new in that. So in waterfalls, nothing new to be added. In prototyping, once it is fixed, the model is final. In spiral, this constant development not suitable for small things, but for other, always there is something or the development in that, something add on. There is incremental model happening there. Okay, so these are the 100 bits of the MCQ. Next, we'll be proceeding towards the case study based MCQs. So we have totally 18 case study based MCQs. I am thinking to take 3 case study based MCQs every day so that in 6 days we can cover off all the case study based MCQs. Okay, so I hope you found this revision useful, friends, and please kindly do the revision. Don't hesitate to stop it. Keep on studying and definitely you will reach the goal. So with saying this, I'll say goodbye. Take care and happy studies.